press the bell icon on our YouTube app and never miss another video from SpotboyE.
We are in conversation with a very big celebrity today. It's the one and only Kajol. Hi Kajol, thank you so much for being on SpotboyE.
Not at all, my pleasure.
Kajol, tell us, we'll start with your movie coming up by Pradeep Sarkar, Helicopter Eela. And I'm not going to call it a comeback because I've read you saying that why are you calling it a comeback every now and then.
I find it odd that every time I do a film it becomes a comeback. Helicopter Eela, basically the title comes from the hashtag of helicopter moms. But helicopter moms have been Indian moms from time immemorial. We all have those mothers. Hum sab ki maa waisi hoti hai, you know, who's constantly interested in our lives. मंडराती रहती है डब्बा खाना बेटा खाना खाया बेटा सोए बेटा ये किया बेटा वो किया तो आई थिंक दैट इज़ व्हाट द इंडियन मदर इज़ बेसिकली बट यस ईला जो है वो थोड़ी सी ज़्यादा है उससे भी एंड शी जस्ट टेक्स इट टू नॉचेस हायर एंड बट एट द सेम टाइम शी इज़ लवेबल एंड यू डेफिनेटली फॉरगिव हर for all her funny quirks and eccentricities and little extra behavior also somewhere down the line because you know for a fact that whatever she is doing she's coming from love she's agar dabba bana rahi hai it's because I love my son if she's checking up on him it's because I love my son whatever she is doing in the film is also because she loves him
yeah
so you forgive her for whatever she's doing
was that the reason that drew you to the script and you identified with it are you indulgent in real life?
I think most people will identify with Eela. Either they'll see themselves in her or they'll definitely see their mothers in her.
Yeah.
Or so it's something that I think everybody will identify with. This relationship between the mother and son is very, very beautifully shown. And what's done is that it talks about women's empowerment. It talks about who you are as a person. It talks about all the little things that we give up and sacrifice in becoming a certain mom tag and you know how we don't even realize it and at that and later we realize that oh my god is this it is this my son is grown up what's going to happen now so I think it's very interestingly done there's a line in the trailer actually where Riddhi turns around and he says like you know but that's all you do all day long aap pura din yahi karte ho And she's like, हाँ अगर मैं तुम्हें नहीं तुझे नहीं देखूंगी ये तो मेरा काम है तुझे नहीं देखूंगी और क्या करूंगी तो दैट्स एग्जैक्टली हाउ एंड यू नो ही इज लाइक वेयर इज दैट ईला हु यू यूज्ड टू टॉक अबाउट हु यूज्ड टू सिंग हु यूज्ड टू डांस हु यूज्ड टू डू ऑल द इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग्स इन लाइफ वो ईला कहाँ है एंड सो यू हैव टू गो आउट एंड फाइंड दोज पीसेज ऑफ योर सेल्फ
Identity.
That, parts of your identity, not your entire identity, but parts of your identity that you've forgotten, lost along the way in becoming this super perfect, super cool mom.
So how are you in real life when it comes to your children? I mean, are you also extremely indulgent?
I hope not. I hope I am a lot like Eela because she's an amazing mother. But I don't think I am to that extent. I definitely am not. I was when the kids were younger, definitely. But I think now as they're growing older, somewhere down the line, I am also trying to be cooler about it and calmer about it. And I think it's very necessary as a parent also somewhere down the line. Jaise meri maa mujhe kehti thi, ke, you know, I have to have faith in my upbringing.
Yeah.
So I think somewhere down the line, I also have to turn around and have faith in my own upbringing that whatever I have taught them will take effect and that they will practice what I have preached to them.
Well, I'm sure you have held yourself back from movies to an extent because of motherhood and...
I did because when my son was born and when my daughter was born, I did want to spend as much time as possible because they were very small at that time. And but I didn't do it for them, I did it for me.
Yeah.
I did it because
Stems
I wanted
from love.
To do it. Yes, exactly. I did it for me. I wanted to do that for them. I enjoyed it thoroughly and I wouldn't miss it for anything in the world.
Parts of identity going to come back here now? You're going to go further into movies a little faster?
I honestly don't know. Depends on what kinds of scripts I get. I hope and pray that I get good scripts because bad scripts are a dime a dozen. I think that you to find a good script, you really, really need to look hard. But I'm talking to a lot of people, so let's see. I hope it works out.
How do these, when these scripts come to you on table today, compared to when you were, you know, doing a lot of movies earlier?
Right.
How do you see this change in scenario? Do you see the change for the better or for the worse?
Definitely for the better. No two ways about it. I am more picky now. I am more choosy now. Also, I think it's very clear. I think I have made it very clear that I'm not willing to do a run-of-the-mill kind of a film. So I'm not willing to do the kind of film that will require me to do, you know, just about anything, or I have nothing meaningful to say. So I think filmmakers in that way are very, very clear about it, that if they want to approach me for a film, they will approach me for a film with something more meaty behind it.
But when you see cinema, my question was actually that, do you see actually better cinema today than what?
I think yes, on an international stage, we are finally at that place where most films, I wouldn't say all, but yes, most films are being made for an international audience as well. At least, if not an international audience, our own audiences which have seen international films. So the bar for making films and the standard for making films has definitely gone up.
Do you agree that the emotion or the in the content is lacking, the depth is lacking, which was earlier present?
No, I don't think so. I definitely don't think so. I think people generally, I think what we thought of romance 10 years back or 15 years back was about, you know, if you talk about, even for that matter, you know, where they die for their love, or Leila Majnu ka jo pyar hota tha, wo aaj ke zamane mein mere ko nahi lagta hai ki koi feel karta hai. Nobody feels like that.
So I there's feel not that, that intensity.
There isn't that intensity. In today's day and age, the age has changed, the kind of people have changed. We don't feel that much to that level, like vengeance or mar jao iske
liye. Possessiveness.
So that is something that, I wouldn't say possessiveness, I would say more like the depth of feeling of all the major emotions. I feel that we don't, society as a whole has, I think, kind of leveled down and become calmer in that respect.
Okay. How was it in your childhood? How would you compare your mom to
Eela? My mom was actually nothing at all like Eela. She was really cool, and she was really like one of the most forward-thinking mothers ever. She had the most amazing time with me, and she discussed everything with me, whether it was from death to philosophy to, you know, life to failure to success to everything. So in a strange way, it was almost like she was preparing me for life by living her life in front of me. Very openly, very normally, not making a big deal out of it, but just going ahead and doing it.
She was very progressive.
Yeah, very definitely. Very
but you
brave.
Are different.
I don't.
Now let's compare the two. I mean,
I don't. I hope and pray that I do. If I do even 50% of what my mother did with me, I think I will have done a fabulous job. And I do try my best to make sure that all the things that she taught me, I am able to convey to my children. Beliefs, philosophies, more than beliefs and philosophies, a way of looking at life, looking at charity, compassion, social work for that matter.
Yeah, she does it a lot.
She does it a lot. And but she's always been doing this. So it was never about showing it to the world or talking about it. It was just there. It was part of our lives, that you are a responsible citizen. Even at the age of 5, you are a citizen. You are of the world. And you have to do your bit and contribute to the world in whichever way you can. Whether it's a 5-rupee note to one organization, whether it's your pocket money going to a social cause, or you know, whether it's feeding hungry people on the road. So that's something that we've always done from the time that we were kids. And yeah, I have tried my level best to make sure that even my kids feel that way about all the things that I talk to them about, whether it's life, whether it's death, again, charity, compassion, being one world, one life.
Did that help you a lot? That progressive thinking in readying yourself for the industry?
I think, yes, of course, more than readying myself for the industry, more than that, I think it's about facing your life with head on, with a sense of responsibility. If you do a wrong, if you take responsibility, it doesn't happen. It becomes a learning experience. And that's exactly the way I feel I look at life today. I don't think that I've made so many mistakes as I have had learning experiences. I have learned from my experiences to change my perspective, or in a lot of ways, a lot of small lessons along the way that have hopefully made me a better person today.
I read you saying somewhere, I don't care what people say about me, but how do you take this social media in today's times when people say n number of things and, you know.
I think lots of people say lots of things on social media.
Yeah.
I think everybody who has a phone has social media, and not necessary that all of them are kind, compassionate souls.
Because ye ek nahi cheez hai, us waqt nahi thi when your mom was reading you.
Bilkul. But I think that again, that has to be taken in perspective. You have to take it in perspective. If you have one person saying something negative about you, or even five people saying something negative about you, there are another 20,000 people mm-hmm. who are saying so many positive and fabulous and lovely things about you. So if you look at it from a question of statistics, it's like 0.01.
So you let it?
You have to. You can't sit down and be affected by it, or, you know, lose any sleep over it. It's not worth it.
You also have a new phenomena around you in this today's times, which is paparazzi coming very close, especially mm-hmm. for star kids.
Yeah.
And I'm sure you're faced it with Yug and Nysa mm-hmm. also. Do you really get ruffled there?
Not really. I think now that they're a little grown up, I don't think I get worried so much about it, because I know for a fact that they are going to be okay. Mm. You know, they have learned how to handle it better. So I think the most important thing is for, as a parent, is that you want to know that they are going to be okay. And I know my kids are going to be okay.
When the cameras come very close, aisa nahi hota ki?
Kabhi aate nahi hai, koi aata nahi hai. I think fortunately for me, most of the times, my kids, we have security and we make sure that, you know, everybody is at a distance. Nobody is really trying to be, you know, push themselves over us or anything like that. Nobody's tried so far.
We spoke about content, Kajol, which was very high. I thought the depth was very high when you did films. The songs also, I thought, were much better. Do you think the songs today are as good as
that? You know, I had this conversation with somebody else today, and I think the one thing that I told her, which I totally believe, is that if you had asked me when I was doing films, whether the music of today was better or whether the music of R.D. Burman was better, I would have said R.D. Burman. So every age, we will think that the music of then was better, music of before was better than it is today. But if you ask the kids of today what they think of the music of the 90s or of the music of the 80s, they will turn around and they will tell you that, listen, I love the music right now. I mean, there is fabulous music right now. So somewhere down the line, I think we have to also realize that the world has changed. Technology has changed. And in that same way, creativity has changed. Acting has changed today. The way we make movies has changed today. So if we thought that movies earlier were better, that's not true. Because movies today are completely different. You cannot compare the two times. Because again, there are two different types of societies that we are catering to. Two different societies whose reflections we are showing. Two different societies that we are catering to. And two different audiences. Today's audience is different.
Yeah.
So the music is catered for today's audience and today's generation. Movies are catered for today's audience and today's generation.
You mean to say, jis hisab se demand hai, usi supply usi hisab se ho rahi hai.
Bilkul.
Okay, one, it seems to be very progressive thinking what you are saying, and really reflects your mom here. But just one last question, and on again progressive thinking, the interview will be incomplete if I don't ask you, all is well between you and Karan Johar now. And it does reflect.
Absolutely.
How did it? I mean, you just thought of... I mean...
Everything is absolutely fine right now, and I don't need to say anything else to that.
Thank you, Kajol. Thank you so much for being on SpotboyE.
It
was great talking to you.
Thank you.